Off they went. There was no room for the mother elephants in the car, so they ran behind, lifting their trunks so as not to breathe in the dust. Alas, that very day, the king of the elephants, during his walk, had eaten a bad mushroom. It had poisoned him. He had been very ill. So ill that he had died. It was a terrible misfortune. After his funeral, the oldest elephants met together to choose a new king. Just at that moment, they heard a noise and turned round. What a wonderful sight they saw! It was Babar arriving in his car, with all the elephants running and shouting, "Oh, here they are! Here they are! They have come back! Hello, Babar! Hello, Arthur! Hello, Celeste! What lovely clothes! What a beautiful car!" Then Cornelius, the oldest elephant of all, said in his quavering voice, "My dear friends, we must have a new king. Why not choose Babar? He has come back from the town where he has lived among humans and learnt much. Let us offer him the crown." All the elephants thought that Cornelius had spoken wisely, and they listened eagerly to hear what Babar would say.
I thank you all, said Babar, but before accepting the crown, I must tell you that on our journey in the car, Celeste and I got engaged to be married. If I become your king, she will be your queen.
Long live Queen Celeste! Long live King Babar! The elephants shouted with one voice, and that is how Babar became king!
"Cornelius," said Babar, "you have such good ideas that I shall make you a general, and when I get my crown, I will give you my hat. In a week's time, I am going to marry Celeste.
We will give a grand party to celebrate our marriage and our coronation. And Babar asked the little birds to take invitations to all the animals.